Hello students, now I'm here with you and you're welcome in maths online class. During taking online class, keep NCERT book and a notebook with you. By that you can better understand the topic. Okay, so in previous topics we have discussed about the trigonometric ratios and some specific trigonometric ratios. I hope so you have got those things. Okay, now I'm here with a new topic, that is trigonometric ratios of complementary angles. So today we are going to discuss on the topic, this topic, and also we will discuss here on trigonometric identities. Just like you have studied algebraic identities, so there are some trigonometric identities. So today we are going to discuss in these two topics. Okay, so let's start the topic, trigonometric ratios of complementary angle. Okay, so you can see in a triangle, it is a right angle triangle, and one angle is alpha and second one is beta. So we know very well. So see what is complementary angle. Two angles whose sum is 90 degree are called complementary angles. Okay, now consider the right triangle shown below. So we can see in this triangle, one angle is right angle because it is a right angle triangle, and remaining two angles are alpha and beta. Okay, so by angle sum property, in this triangle alpha and beta are complementary angles. Why? Because by the angle sum property, we know the sum of all the angles in a triangle is 180 degree. So we can write alpha plus beta plus 90 is equal to 180 or not. Okay, now alpha plus beta is equal to 180 minus 90, that's why 90 will come. So alpha and beta are the here complementary angles. Okay, how we can see that? Because according to the definition of complementary angles, if the sum of any two angles is 90 degree, so those are the complementary angles. Okay, and it is customary to represent complementary angles in a right triangle as follows. In first figure we have written alpha and beta, but we know very well, if we will let here, right angle is alpha, that is 90 degree, and angle C is theta. So angle A will be, surely it will be 90 minus theta, because both are the complementary angles. Just simply, if we are taking angle C is x degree suppose, so what will be the value of angle A? That will be 90 minus x, because the sum of angle A and angle C is 90 degree and both the angles are complementary angles. Okay, now some common complementary angles. Sine 90 minus A is equal to cos A, cos 90 minus A is equal to sin A, tan 90 minus A is equal to cot A, cot 90 minus A is equal to tan A, sec 90 minus A is equal to cosec 90 minus A, sorry, cosec A, and cosec 90 minus A is equal to sec A. So these all are the complementary angles. Okay, so see, I'm going to show you something here. Here, this table I have laid out to you. So we are going to discuss in this table on the basis of complementary angle. Okay, so see here, what is the value of sine 30? We can see 1 upon 2, simply we will see. And sine 90 minus 30, what will? Sine 90 minus 30 means sine 90 minus theta. Cos theta or not? Cos theta. Sine 90 minus 30, it is cos theta. So cos 60 is there, that is, you can see it is 1 upon 2. That's why you can see everywhere 45 degree for the two complementary angle is same, because sine 90 minus theta is equal to cos theta and cos 90 minus theta is equal to sine theta. That's why 90 minus 45, because 45 is the mid value of the 90. That's why for two complementary angles, 45 degree value is same. Sin 45 and cos 45, you can see both are the same value. Tan 45 and cot 45, because they are the complementary angles. And sec 45 and cosec 45 values are same. So I hope so you have got it. This one. Now one example for you. In this, given the trigonometric ratios of 30 degree, find all the 6 trigonometric ratios of 60 degree. Question is given to us. 30 degree value for all the 6 ratios, it is given here. This is the full question, and we are going to find out the 60 degree values for all trigonometric ratios. Okay, so cos 30 is equal to, it is given, root 3 upon 2. Sin 30 is equal to 1 upon 2. Tan 30 is equal to 1 upon root 3. And cosec 30 is equal to 2 upon 1. Okay, now sec 30 is equal to 2 upon root 3, and cot 30 is equal to root 3 upon 1. These values are given to us from the questions. Okay, now solution. Since 30 and 60 degree are complementary angles, we know, because the sum of 30 plus 60 90, and complementary angle means the sum of two angles 90 degree, those are complementary. So we can use the method of co-ratios to determine trigonometric ratios of 60 degree using those of 30 degree as shown below. Now see, sin 60 is equal to, but 60 can be broken as 90 minus 30 or not. Very well. See here, in place it was given here sin 60. So in place of sin, we have no change, simply written here sin. And 60 can be broken as 90 minus 30 or not. Yes. So in place of 60, we have written here 90 minus 30. So 90 minus 30 is there. 90 minus 30 is there. 60. That's why we have written here 60. Now, and we know that sine 90 minus theta is cos theta, and theta is here 30. So in place of sine 90 minus theta, we have written cos theta is here 30. The value of cos 30 is root 3 upon 2. Okay, that got it. Now second, cos 60 is equal to, again we need to break 60. 90 minus 30, 90 minus 30, and cos 90 minus theta is sine theta. That's why it is sin 30, and that's the value of cos 60 is 1 upon 2. That, okay. Now tan 60, same thing. In place of 60, we can write 90 minus 30, and tan 90 minus theta from complementary angle, that is cot theta. So we have written here cot 30, and the value of cot 30 is given to us, that is root 3 upon 1. The value of tan 60 is also root 3 upon 1. Now cosec 60, again we have break here 60, that is 90 minus 30, and cosec 90 minus theta is sec theta, and theta is a 30 degree, sec 30, and the value of sec 30 is given to us from the question, that is 2 upon root 3. So the also the value of cosec 60 is 2 upon root 3. Okay, now sec 60, again we need to break 60 in 90 minus 30. Okay, so, and we know that sec 90 minus theta is cosec theta, and theta is 30, and the value of cosec 30 is given in the question, that is 2. That's why we have written sec 60 is equal to 2. Now cot 60 is equal to cot 90 minus 30, same procedure. 60 is broken as 90 minus 30, and cot 90 minus theta is tan theta. So tan 30, and the value of tan 30 is given in the question, that's why it is 1 upon root 3. So this is the question, full question of related to the complementary angles. Now we are going to move towards the next topic, that is trigonometric identities. Okay, so in class 10th, there are basically three trigonometric identities which we learned in trigonometry chapter. Okay, so first identity is there, beta, cos square theta plus sin square theta is equal to 1. Second is there, 1 plus tan square theta is equal to sec square theta. And third one is there, 1 plus cot square theta is equal to cosec square theta. Okay, so we are going to discuss in these three identities, and how we will prove these identities, that we will learn in this topic. Now proof of trigonometric identities. We have taken here a triangle ABC, where angle C is theta and angle B is 90 degree. An opposite side of 90 degree is always hypotenuse, and opposite side of theta degree always perpendicular. That's why AB is perpendicular and AC is hypotenuse, and the remaining third side is base. So BC is the ratio. Okay, figure got it. Okay, so let's start. In a right angle triangle by the Pythagoras theorem, I already taught you, that is perpendicular square plus base square is equal to hypotenuse square. So from the triangle ABC, we can write here AB square plus BC square is equal to AC square. We can write it or not? By the Pythagoras theorem. Now, dividing both sides by AC square. Okay, so what the procedure? We are going to find a prove three identities here, and we have three sides in a triangle, in a right angle triangle. So one by one we are going to divide by the side by to the given Pythagoras theorem. Okay, so firstly we are dividing by the hypotenuse, that is AC. So AB square upon AC square we have written here, plus BC square upon AC square we have written, is equal to AC square upon AC square. Okay, now we can write in this form, AB upon AC whole square plus BC upon AC whole square, and there was AC square upon AC square, both are cancelled. So we have written there 1. And from the triangle AB upon AC, see here, I am showing you AB upon AC. What is AB upon AC? That is sin theta. AB upon AC is here sin theta, and BC upon AC is here cos theta. So in place of AB upon AC, we can write sin theta. Okay, in place of AB upon AC, we have written here sin square theta. In place of BC upon AC, we have written cos square theta. Okay, just we have written from here to there, so no need to worry. In place of upon AB upon AC, we have written sin theta whole square, plus BC upon AC, we have written cos theta whole square. So what we are getting? Cos square theta plus sin square theta is equal to 1. This is the first trigonometric identity. Okay, we can, by the transposing, we can get two more, that is cos square theta is equal to 1 minus sin square theta, and sin square theta is equal to 1 minus cos square theta. These we are getting after the transposing the terms of cos square theta and sin square theta. Now see the second identity is, again dividing equation first by AB square. So what is the first equation? That is Pythagoras theorem, AB square plus BC square is equal to AC square. Now we are going to divide by, first we have divided by AC square, that was the hypotenuse. Now we are going to divide by AB square, that is the perpendicular. So AB square upon AB square plus BC square upon AB square is equal to AC square upon AB square. Okay, so AB upon AB whole square we can write it or not? Okay, plus BC upon AB whole square we have written here, and is equal to AC upon AB we have written here, whole square, sorry. And AB and AB beta cancel, so we have written here 1. And BC upon AB, see the figure, BC upon AB, BC upon AB is the BC upon AB according to the theta. What is BC upon AB? That is cot square theta. BC upon AB is here cot square theta. BC upon AB is here cot square theta, and is equal to third one is there, BC upon AB is equal to cot square theta, and AC upon AB is here, that is AC upon AB, AC is the hypotenuse and AB is the perpendicular, that is cosec square theta. AC upon AB is the cosec square theta. So we have written over here, so we can get the identities 1 plus cot square theta is equal to cosec square theta. This is the third one, got it? 1 plus cot square theta is equal to cosec square theta. Okay, now next one is there. Let's see what we get if we divide equation by BC square. So now we are going to divide by the third side. So we have written here AB, same again Pythagoras theorem we have written here. So AB square upon BC square plus BC square upon BC square is equal to AC square upon BC square. So we can get AB upon BC whole square plus BC upon BC whole square is equal to AC upon BC whole square. Now we can see AB upon BC from the triangle. AB is the perpendicular and BC is the base. So that is tan square theta. Plus BC and BC both are cancelled,
and square of 1, that is 1. So we have written here 1. And AC upon BC, AC is here, hypotenuse, and BC is their base. Okay, so hypotenuse upon base, that is sec square theta. So identity we can get here, tan square theta plus 1 is equal to sec square theta. Tan square theta plus 1 is equal to sec square theta. This is the INT. So we have learned today 3 INTs here. Okay, first one is there, sin square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. Second one is there, 1 plus cot square theta is equal to cosec square theta. And third one is there, tan square theta plus 1 is equal to sec square theta. These INTs are very, very important for us. We are going to solve the numericals. Okay, so let's see some examples. Okay, so we are going to show you some examples here. Examples for the trigonometric INTs, how we will solve it. One question in front of you, beta. Problem first, you can see here. Problem 1. It is proof is there, and we need to question is given to us 1 minus cos square theta in bracket and cosec square theta. Okay, this is the short form of cosec square theta, CSC. But directly we have written here COSEC, but it is the short form of cosec square theta. So we have is equal to 1, we need to prove it. Now solution, let A is equal to 1 minus cos square theta into cosec square theta, and B is equal to 1. Simply you can write also LHS part and RHS if you want. Here we have taken A and B two parts. Okay, we have taken A parts LHS and B part RHS. Okay, so A is equal to 1 minus cos square theta into cosec square theta. And because the first INT we know very well, it is sin square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. Okay, so I already told we can transpose cos square theta because we are going to find out the value of 1 minus cos square theta. So sin square theta is equal to 1 minus cos square theta. So in place of 1 minus cos square theta, what we can write? Sin square theta. Written here, A is equal to sin square theta into cosec square theta. And I already told you, beta, cosec square theta is the reciprocal of cosec theta is the reciprocal of sin theta. And sec theta is the reciprocal of cos theta, and cot theta is the reciprocal of tan theta. So in place of cosec square theta, we can write 1 upon sin square theta or not. That's why we have written here 1 upon sin square theta. Now sin square theta and sin square theta both are cancelled. So what is remaining here part? 1. So A is equal to 1, that's why A is equal to B. So this question is proved. Okay. Now one more problem. Two question is given to us, sec theta under root 1 minus sin square theta is equal to 1. Okay, so again we will use the same INT, same procedure we will do. A is equal to let LHS and B is equal to RHS. If you don't want to let here, so simply you can write LHS is equal to this, RHS is equal to this. Okay, so A is equal to sec under root 1 minus sin square theta. Again we will find out, we need to that in first question we have find out the value of 1 minus cos square theta, but here we'll find out the value of 1 minus sin square theta. So we need to transpose sin theta square theta, so we can get cos square theta is equal to 1 minus sin square theta. Okay, so then A is equal to sec under root cos square theta, because we 1 minus sin square theta is equal to cos square theta, and under root of cos square theta is cos theta. So we can get sec theta into cos theta, and again reciprocal. I already told you, sec theta and cos theta are reciprocal to each other. So in place of cos theta, we can write sec theta. If you want to break sec theta, so in place of sec theta, you can write 1 upon cos theta. Okay, so 1 upon sec theta and sec theta are cancelled. That's why A is equal to 1, so that A is equal to B. That is the proved question. Okay, now one more problem for you, problem 3. Tan theta into sin theta plus cos theta is equal to sec theta. Okay, so now we are going to solve this question. Again we have let here A and B part.
A is equal to tan theta sin theta plus cos theta. Now A is equal to tan theta can be written as sin theta upon cos theta. Tan theta can be written as sin theta upon cos theta. And into sin theta plus cos. Now sin theta into sin theta, that is sin square theta upon cos theta. Okay. Plus cos square theta upon cos theta. How cos square coming? It means cos theta upon 1 was here. Cos theta upon 1. And we are going to multiply cos theta both in numerator and denominator also. So when we will multiply it cos theta by numerator, to cos square will come, and by denominator 1, to 1 into cos theta, cos theta. Okay, now you can see both denominator are same. Why we are doing? To make the denominator equal. Otherwise you can take LCM also here. Same thing you will get. Now sin square theta plus cos square theta upon cos theta. So sin square theta plus cos square theta is 1 from the first identity. So A is equal to 1 upon cos theta, that is sec theta. So we have proved here. I hope so you have understood to all three examples. Okay, now I am giving you some reliable questions. Okay, I am sending you with this, and you need to solve exercise 8.3 and 8.4 of NCERT. If any kind of problem is there, we can talk to me. And but you need to think in trigonometry, formula, identities and trigonometric ratios are very, very important. So first you need to practice on those one. After that you need to start, and it is a very, very important chapter also. Okay, so keep these things in your mind. Start the chapter, start the questions, and best of luck you all. Okay, thank you everyone. Have a nice day.